Hello learners, in this video we will be discussing about CRO. So CRO is a most common instrument being used in almost all the laboratories, in the college, also in the industries, to visualize the waveforms, right? So this is the instrument called CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. So suppose in our laboratory a student constructed and testing a rectifier circuit, and he want to see the input waveform as well as the input sinusoidal waveform as well as the output rectified waveform. So basically, to see and observe the waveform, he need a instrument called the CRO, oscilloscope, right? So without oscilloscope he cannot see the waveform, right? So using the oscilloscope you can observe the waveform, also you can take measurements like voltage, current, time and frequency, you can take measurement also. So it is a very useful instrument in the laboratory and research industries to observe and take measurements the variations in voltages and current in the form of waveforms. Now basically there are two types of oscilloscopes: cathode ray oscilloscopes and digital storage oscilloscopes. So in this video our focus is on cathode ray oscilloscope. So I'm going to explain the cathode ray oscilloscopes in detail. So cathode ray oscilloscope is an instrument used to visualize the signal waveform, right? The idea of this oscilloscope, idea behind the visualizing the waveform, is generating a cathode ray. Cathode ray means electron beam. Here ray refers to the beam of electrons generated from the cathode. That is why it is called cathode ray. So generating a electron beam from cathode and directing the beam to the screen, to the special screen, where when the electron beam hits, a spotlight appears, a luminous spot appears on the screen, right? And this electron beam will be maybe deflected to the entire screen and to display the waveforms of our interest. That is the idea, right? So by generating the high speed electron beam and directing it towards the special screen and to cover the entire screen, it is deflected, right, in both horizontal and vertical direction. That is the fundamental idea behind the cathode ray oscilloscope. So for that we need a basically we need a CRT tube and power supply and some electronic circuits, supporting circuits, to display the waveform, like generating signal generation as well as signal processing circuits. Okay, first of all the idea is we have to generate the electron beam, right, and direct it towards the screen, and we have to deflect the waveform in horizontal and vertical direction to cover the entire screen. So these are the three requirements. So for doing this, basically we need a electron, we need a setup to generate the electron beam, right? First we require electron beam. To generate the electron beam, we need a setup called electron gun assembly, right? So the electron gun assembly generates the high speed focused electron beam. Now this electron beam is to be deflected in horizontal direction as well as vertical direction of the screen, in the screen. For that we need a deflection plate assembly, right? So to deflect the electron beam in horizontal direction, we need a horizontal plates, and we set up plates called horizontal plates. And to deflect the screen in the vertical direction, we need a set of plates called vertical plates. Of course, we need a screen to display the waveform, special screen coated inside with a special material. So these three is the major requirement: electron gun assembly, deflection plate assembly, and screen. These three is the major parts of the internal parts of the CRO. These three major parts should be covered by an envelope, glass envelope, right? It's nothing but a glass tube. So it's a conical or special geometrical shape tube, evacuated or maintains vacuum inside, right? So glass envelope is nothing but a conical tube, glass tube, which maintains vacuum inside. Why vacuum? Because the generated electron beam by the electron gun should be directed towards the screen, right? So during the path there should not be any air molecules, right? So it should not be disturbed by any other air molecules. Hence we have to maintain vacuum inside the glass envelope. Okay, now we understand that the three major parts inside the CRO is a electron gun, right? Electron gun assembly and deflection plate assembly and screen, right? So here we can see the electron gun assembly, electron gun, right? Consisting the cathode and grid and anodes. And here we have a two set of plates to deflect the electron beam in horizontal direction as well as vertical direction. And this is the screen, right? Coated with some special material, depends on the color of the display, whatever you require. Okay, so these are the three major parts we are able to see in this simple three-dimensional view of the glass tube, conical tube covering these three parts. Okay, so this is the two-dimensional diagram for CRO. It's a conical glass tube. Now let us discuss in detail about the electron gun assembly, where the electron beam is generated. So in an electron gun, we have a cathode made of nickel cylinder with oxygen coating, right? When this cathode is heated, it produces large number of electrons. So this cathode is heated indirectly, right? So here the cathode is heated indirectly to produce large number of electrons in all directions. But our requirement is a beam of electrons in one particular direction, right? Beam of electrons should be directed from the cathode towards the screen. So for that we have a setup called grid. So grid is, we have a plates called grid next to the cathode, maintained at the negative potential, why negative potential? We know the charge of the electron is negative, and next to the production of the electron, large number of electrons, we have a grid maintaining at the negative potential. Hence, this grid will repulse the electrons generated from the cathode. So, it depends on the amount of potential given to the grid. Large number of electrons can be repelled, and some of the electrons only will be permitted out, coming out of the grid. There will be a small hole in the grid through which the electrons, number of the beam of electrons coming out of it, right? When large number of electrons are repelled by the grid, right? So now, when you adjust the grid potential, when you increase the grid potential, the width of the beam will decrease. When you decrease the grid potential, the width of the beam will increase. Hence, this is called the intensity variation in the CRO. So, in the front side of the CRO, you will have a knob called intensity variation. When you vary it, actually you are varying the grid potential. And next to the grid, we have a set of plates called anode, maintaining at the positive potential. That's why we call it as anode. So the purpose of this is to attract the electrons beam coming from the grid, right? And also to focus the electron beam to the thin point on the screen. So that is why it is called focusing anode. Right? So by varying the potential on the focusing anode, you will be able to vary the focusing point. Right? You can make the beam as a sharp, you can make the electron beam as a sharp to that sharp point. So for that purpose we have a anode called focusing anode, maintaining at positive potential. So next to the anode, focusing anode, we have another anode called accelerating anode. See, now out of the focusing anode we have generated the electron beam to the fine point with adjustable width. But now the another important characteristics of the beam is speed of the electron beam. The electron beam should be it should accelerate in very high speed, so that we can when it hits the screen, we will get the illumination on the screen. So for that purpose, for increasing the acceleration of the electron, we have a anode called accelerating anode, maintaining at the positive potential. So this acceleration anode, maintained at the positive potential, will accelerate the electrons by attracting towards it and increases the speed of the electron. That's all. Simply it increases the acceleration of the electrons. Hence, now we get the focused, accelerated electron beam coming out of the acceleration anode. When it hits the screen, at the center you will get a luminous spot, right? Now this electron beam is allowed to pass through two set of plates. The reason is, suppose now if this arrangement is not there, we will get only the luminous spot at the center, that's all. But our requirement is we have to cover the entire screen, right? We have to cover the entire screen of this scope, so that we can display the waveform. So the scope screen is in a rectangular form. It have the x axis and y axis. So we have to move the luminous part at the center in the x direction, horizontal direction, from left extreme to the right extreme. For that purpose, we have plates called horizontal deflection plates. Horizontal deflection plates. Right? Similarly, we have another set of plates called vertical deflection plates to move the luminous spot at the center in y direction, that is up and down. Okay, so now let us see how does it work. Right, and about the so when the electron beam passing through the vertical deflection plates, if there is this is nothing but a set of plates, right? The electron beam passes through the in between the plates to the screen. Now if there is no voltage applied on this plate, the electron beam hits the screen at the center and we get the luminous spot at the center. Now when we are applying the electrical voltage between these plates and the electrical field is created between these two plates, electrical field, right, the electron have the negative charge and this will be deflected by the electrical field. It is called electrostatic deflection. Electrostatic deflection. Hence, this electron beam of negative charge deflects by the electrical voltage applied between the plates. Now the question is, you have to connect the voltage. When you connect the voltage across the plates, it will deflect. Okay. Suppose, when no voltage applied across the plates, it hits the center part of the screen. When you apply the voltage like this, that is, when you connect the positive to the upper plate and negative to the lower plate, so what happens? Upper plate is positively charged, lower plate is negatively charged. So in between the plate, we have an electric potential, electric voltage, and there is an electrostatic deflection. Now, this electron beam deflected towards the positive plate, because we know the charge of the electron is negative and it will attract towards the positive. So the positive plate attracts the electron beam, and from the center, this luminous part moves up, right? It moves up. Like this, when upper plate is positive and lower plate is negative, electron beam at the center moving from the center to the up, right, in y direction, in positive part of the y direction. Now question is, how far this beam will move from the center? It depends on the amount of voltage you are connecting across this plate, right? When you increase the potential difference between these plates, this luminous part will further move up. Okay, so from the center to move the extreme up, you can give the maximum potential between these two plates. That is the idea. Okay, when you decrease the potential difference between this positive and negative plate, that means when you decrease the amount of positive charge on the positive plate, the beam, the luminous part will come towards the center. Okay, when you increase the positive charge on this plate, it will move away from the center up, in the up direction. And when you decrease the positive charge on this positive plate, it will come towards the center. That is the idea. Right? when you remove the voltage, it will come to the center. Now, assume that now you have removed the potential difference between the positive and negative plate, right, like this. Now it comes to the center. Now, I connect like this, the upper plate connecting to the negative and lower plate connecting to the positive. Now what will happen? Upper plate connecting to the negative and lower plate connecting to the positive. Now from the center, the luminous part will go in the downward direction. Right? So how far, how much voltage we are giving, that much distance it will move further from the, away from the center point. So what we understand is, by varying the potential, by connect, depends on the direction, right, positive and negative, we are connecting to the plates, we are able to move the luminous part from the center to the upward and downward. Okay, so here I have explained to you with the simple DC voltage by connecting fixed positive and negative. But instead, when you give AC, that means for some time it will be, upper plate will be positive and lower plate will be negative. And for some time lower upper plate will be negative and lower plate will be positive. So what will happen? The center luminous part from the center, it will go up and down. Okay, that is the idea. Now what about the horizontal deflection plates? So we have one more set of plates called horizontal deflection plates. When you apply the, when you are not applying any voltage between these plates, again the electron beam hits at the center, right, when no voltage applied between the plates. When you apply the voltage, like the one side negative, one side positive and other side negative, like this, in this diagram, one side positive and the other side negative. So now what happens? This positive plate attracts the electron beam, and hence the luminous part at the center goes to the right extreme in the x direction, like this. It was here at the center when no voltage applied. When the voltage applied like this, positive and negative, it goes to the right extreme. It moves to the right extreme. Right? It moves right actually. So it depends on the voltage between the positive and negative. When you increase the voltage, it will move away from the center. And when you give the maximum voltage between positive and negative, it will the luminous part will go to the right extreme. And when you decrease it, again the luminous part from the right extreme, it will travel towards the center and it will come back. Okay, when you decrease the potential voltage between the plates or remove the voltage between the plates. Now when you connect in the opposite way, when this plate is negative and the other plate is positive, now the positive plate again attracts the electron beam, but now it towards the left extreme, right? So now this positive plate attracts the electron beam towards the left direction. So when you give the maximum voltage between this positive and negative, the luminous part will go to the left extreme. When you decrease, it will come towards the center. Now what we understood is, by varying the potential difference, by varying the voltage between this positive and negative between these plates, we are able to move the luminous part in the horizontal direction. Right? Hence it is called horizontal plates. So now we are able to move the luminous part in the horizontal direction as well as in vertical direction by the two set of plates called horizontal plates and vertical plates. See, but here in the horizontal plate, okay, in a horizontal, in the horizontal plates, when you are applying the voltage, it can move in the horizontal direction, right? Now our requirement is, the luminous part, initially when no voltage is applied, the luminous part is at the center, right? But our requirement is from the center, it has to go to the left extreme, right extreme, and come back to the center, and go to the left extreme, and come back to the center. Again, come back to the center. So that means the luminous part should oscillate between the light right extreme and the left extreme, so that we will get a horizontal line, so that we can scan the entire point in the horizontal line. For that, we have to apply a signal like this, called sawtooth waveform or sweep wave, right? It is also called as time-based waveform. With respect to time, starting from the negative voltage at the negative at T naught, it has to increase towards T1, right? From negative, it is keep on increasing towards zero at T1, and again increasing at some higher value, some positive value at T2, right? So T naught, T1, T2. The voltage starting when the voltage increases from T0 to T0 towards 0 at T1 and some positive voltage at T2. So when this slope is applied to the, that is the when the voltage between this positive and negative plate is increased with respect to this slope T0, T1, T2, what will happen? The beam at the luminous part at the center will increase, right? It will increase to the right extreme. Okay? That is, initially the luminous part is at the center point. When at T1. Okay? Assume that at T1, when the potential is zero, that means when there is no potential across the, when no voltage applied across the plate, that is, voltage is zero. Here you can see the voltage with respect to time is zero at T1. Okay, so when voltage is zero, the luminous part is at the center. When voltage increases in the positive direction, from T1 to T2, the luminous part increases to the right extreme. And now the luminous part is at the right extreme. Now when you decreases the voltage from the T2 to T1, from T2 to T1, when you decrease the voltage, the luminous part from right extreme, it will come to the center again. Now the voltage is zero again at luminous part it at the center. When you decrease the voltage towards from say zero to negative voltage at T0, right? Now this luminous part at center will start to move to the left direction. Go to the left extreme, okay? At T0, it will go to the left extreme. And again, when you come back, when you increase the voltage from T0 to reach 0, again, from the left extreme, it will come to the center. This is how this luminous part moves in the horizontal direction, okay? So, when you apply this slope, positive slope, from 0 to some positive value, T0 to T2, again coming back to T1, again to moving to the left negative voltage D0, and coming back to T1. So this action, when this action repeats, you get the horizontal line like this on the screen. Okay, so see here, when at T0, the luminous part is at the center. Luminous part is at the center at T1. And when you go, the voltage is at T2, right? T2, it goes to the right extreme. Luminous part goes to the right extreme. and when you again come back to now, the voltage is at the time of T2, the voltage is positive voltage, okay. Now there is a sudden transition from T2 to T3. That is, now the potential is at the positive voltage at time T2, right? The luminous part is at the right extreme of the screen. Now I have to come back to the left extreme. So for that, the voltage is suddenly switched to the negative voltage at no time. That means luminous part from the right extreme goes to the left extreme at no time, okay, or very less time. Now here, now that from T3 the voltages keep on increasing, at T4 it reaches zero. So at T4, coming back to the center, and again it goes to the right extreme at T5, okay. So this is what repeating. So T0, T1, T2, you can see here, and again T3, T4, T5, okay. So when this slope is continuously given, it is called sawtooth waveform. So this kind of sawtooth waveform is applied at the horizontal plate, you get the horizontal line appearing on the screen, okay. So it is called the sweep, horizontal sweep waveform or time based waveform. So to generate this waveform, we need a circuit, electronic circuit called time based generator or sawtooth waveform generator, okay. So that is what we hear, time based generator circuit. It is also called a sawtooth waveform generator circuit, which generate the sawtooth waveform, which is given to the it should be given to the horizontal deflection plate. But it is actually given, before it is given to the horizontal deflection plate, it is amplified using a circuit called amplifier, called horizontal amplifier. Why it is amplified? Because sometimes this time based generator output to magnitude of the voltage is not sufficient to bring the luminous part to the right extreme of the screen and the left extreme of the screen, right? The magnitude is may not be sufficient. To increase the magnitude, we have to amplify the sawtooth waveform. For that purpose, we have amplifier called horizontal amplifier, okay. So these two circuit is necessary to move the time based generator, and that is, we need a sawtooth waveform and amplifier. To generate the sawtooth waveform, we need a time based generator, and to amplify it, we need amplifier, okay. Similarly, at the horizontal plates, we have to give only sawtooth waveform to move the luminous part to the left extreme and right extreme to cover the horizontal direction. But what about the vertical direction? So here only we have to give the waveform, the signal to be visualized, right? So what kind of signal we are going to observe on the screen? It may be a sinusoidal waveform, or it may be a rectifier output waveform. So whatever the waveform you want to see, that waveform should be given to the Y plate. Here, this is your input signal. Here you have to give your waveform, right? Suppose if you want to observe the rectifier output waveform, you have to give the rectifier output waveform here only. Or if you want to observe the sinusoidal waveform, you have to give the sinusoidal waveform here. Now this waveform is to be amplified by the vertical amplifier. Why? Because the input signal, or the signal what we are going to observe, may not have a sufficient amplitude to deflect the luminous part in the upward and downward direction. So for that, we have to increase the amplitude. For that, we need amplifier circuit. It is called as vertical amplifier. And this output is not directly given to the vertical plates, it is given through the delay line. So here, why delay line? Simply delays the waveform signal. Before the signal to be visualized, after getting amplified, before given to the plates, it is delayed for some time. The reason is the signal reaching reaching the horizontal plates. Actually, the signal at the horizontal plates and the signal at the vertical plates should start at the same time. that is called synchronization, right? Same time. So otherwise there will be a problem, distortion in the waveform, you cannot see the correct waveform. But horizontal plates here, the horizontal plates receives the signal after it is getting generated and amplified, right? And also triggered by the trigger circuit. So the signal, this horizontal signal took, before the horizontal signal, the sawtooth waveform comes to the horizontal plates, the input signal may come to the vertical plates, right? That is, the input signal may come early to the vertical plates than before the sawtooth waveform comes to the horizontal plates, if there is no delay line. So we have to delay the, we have to delay for some time the input signal, so that both horizontal and vertical plate receives the signal at the same time. For that reason we have a delay line. And we have a high voltage supply and low voltage supply here, power supply, two different type of supply section, high voltage and low voltage. Basically high voltage supply section gives the voltage to the electron gun assembly, because there we need a very high voltage to be maintained at the anode and the grid. Positive potential as well as negative potential should be in a high voltage in terms of 1000 volt, right? So for that purpose we need a high voltage section, power supply section. And another section is low voltage power supply section, which gives the supplies to all these circuits, trigger circuit, time based circuit, the generator circuit, amplifier, everything. For that we need a supply to generate the supply section. We have a low voltage supply section, okay? And what is trigger circuit? See, it is synchronization. What is synchronization? We'll discuss the here. Trigger circuit is basically used to synchronize the horizontal and vertical plates. Now let us continue our discussion here. So when we give a potent when we apply the sawtooth waveform to the horizontal plate, we are getting the horizontal line in the screen. Okay, but right, horizontal line in the screen, when you are giving the sawtooth waveform to the horizontal plates, but no voltage applied on the vertical plates. We are applying the sawtooth waveform to the horizontal plates, but no voltage at the vertical plates, right? Then we will get the horizontal line on the screen. But when you apply the voltage to the vertical plates as well as to the horizontal plates, what will happen? See, here the idea is horizontal plates, for the horizontal plates we have to give the sawtooth waveform, right, to deflect the luminous part in the horizontal direction. To the vertical plates we have to give the vertical plates should be connected to the input signal, to be the input waveform or input signal to be visualized. So for example, assume that this is our input signal, sinusoidal signal, right? So this is the waveform we want to observe on the screen. Now what happens, let us analyze how this waveform will appear on the screen. Now at t naught, at time t naught, look at this both waveform. At time t naught, horizontal plates are given some negative voltage. Okay, here you can see the sawtooth waveform at time t naught, it has some voltage at the negative, right, negative voltage. But in the vertical plates, no voltage, vertical plates no voltage, because it is zero volt. So now what will happen? So luminous part will go to the extreme left, okay. At time t naught, the luminous part will be here, t naught, okay. Now at time t1, look at the sawtooth waveform, 0 volt, voltage is 0, right? This slope from T naught, it approaches 0, right? Now, at T1, the voltage is 0 at the horizontal plate, and the voltage is 0 at the vertical plate also. Look at here, at T1, in this waveform, horizontal plates, that is in sawtooth waveform, voltage is 0, and sinusoidal waveform also, the potential magnitude is 0. Then what happens? The luminous part at T1, the luminous part will come to the center. But from T0 to T1, what about the trace? The luminous part comes from the T0 to T1 in this path, following this sinusoidal path. Why? Because see here, look at the time at T 0.5. This is T0, this is T1, and in between we have a T 0.5 time. So at that particular time, what is the potential at horizontal plate? Some negative voltage, and the potential at vertical plate is more negative voltage. So both are negative. So now listen. At T off, horizontal, the potential at horizontal plate is little positive compared to the potential at T0. Okay, so T0 la negative voltage, more negative. At T off, less negative. That is going towards positive. Positive noki poikittu irukke. Full negative la irundhu positive noki poikittu irukke indha time la T off la horizontal potential. Vertical potential, the potential at the vertical plates on the, again, it is also negative. So now what happens? So luminous part tries to move towards the center. Vertical plate la voltage illaina horizontal line le varum. Vertical plate la voltage irukkiradunala adu enna shape la irukko andha shape laye horizontal nokki varudhu. Okay, so now the luminous part from the left extreme coming towards the right extreme because of this T0 to T1 sawtooth waveform, but following the shape of the vertical volt, the shape of the potential variation at the vertical plates. So you are getting this waveform. Between T0 to T1, you are getting the negative half waveform, negative half of the sinusoidal supply. Now at T1, the luminous part from the center, the horizontal potential, the voltage at the horizontal plates, the voltage at the horizontal plates increases towards T2. That means from the luminous part tries to move from T1 to the right extreme T2. But at the vertical plates we have a potential variation of following this positive half potential, positive half. Positive half cycle, increasing and decreasing from T1 to T1.5, increasing from T1.5 to T2, decreasing. So that is what happening here. The luminous part from T1 to T2, it is not following the path, horizontal path, but it is moves to the T2 through this path, positive half cycle. Okay, so now what happens? This negative half cycle and positive half cycle appears on the screen, right? So the ramp, the thing is, we are able to get the waveform trace, that is a luminous part moves on the screen following this, in this path, T0, T1.5, T2, in the sinusoidal waveform. Now the sinusoidal waveform appears on the screen. But one thing is, this ramp waveform, that is a sawtooth waveform, must be synchronized with the frequency of the input voltage, right? Synchronized means both should start at the same time, right? See here,
here 2 cycle of the ramp equal to 2 cycle of the input. See, T0 to T1, 1 cycle, T1 to T2, 2 cycles, another cycle, 2 cycles. Similarly here, also in the waveform, input signal, T0 to T1, negative half cycle, 1 cycle, T1 to T2, another half cycle, positive half cycle, another cycle, so 2 cycles. So, when the 2 cycles of ramp happens, 2 cycles of input cycle also happens. Then, it means they are synchronized. Right? Now, what about this? Observe this waveform. Now, the same sawtooth waveform is given to the horizontal plates, but the input signal is with little higher frequency. Right? Now, observe that between 2 cycles, T0 to T1, 1 cycle, T1 to T2. So, now observe the follow this waveform, sawtooth waveform. Between T0 to T1, 1 cycle, T1 to T2, another cycle. T1 to T2 is another cycle here, right? So, between T0 to T2, this ramp has 2 cycles, right? Cycle means from T0 to T, following the luminous part traveling from T0 to T1, right? And T1 to T2. This is one, half of the cycle. Then T2 to T1, coming T1 to T0. So, this is actually a cycle, right? So, between T0 to T2, it has 2 cycles. I repeat, so initially it is at T1 at the center, luminous part is at the center, traveling from T1 to T2, coming back from T2 to T1, half cycle. Again, T1 to T0 and coming back from T0 to T1, another half cycle, 2 cycles. So between T0 to T2, this ramp completes 2 cycles. Similarly, here, now observe these waveforms. This is the horizontal, this is the sawtooth waveform or ramp waveform given to the horizontal plates, and this is the input signal given to the vertical plates. Now, between T0 to T2, the sawtooth waveform completes 2 cycles. Here, this T0 to T2 in the input signal, T0 to T2, the input signal completes 4 cycles. Right? That is T0 to, that means 2 complete waveform. See here, 2 cycle of ramp equal to 4 cycle of inputs. Right? 4 cycle of inputs. That is, between T0 to T1, 4 half cycles are there. Between T0 to T2, here you can observe the 4 half cycles. Negative and positive and negative and positive. 4 half cycles. Okay. So, that is the... Now, this is also synchronized. Right? This is also synchronized. So, it can be in multiples. That means 2 cycle of ramp is 2 equal to 2 cycle of input signal synchronized. 2 cycle of ramp equal to 4 cycle of input signals. That is also synchronized. 2 cycle of ramp equal to 8 cycle of input signal. That is also synchronized. Right? That is not a matter. But thing is, you can observe, you can understand the synchronization very clearly here. See, look at this waveform. Between T0 to T2, the ramp, between T0 to T2, the ramp completes one cycle, that is 2 half cycle. From T0 to T0 to T2, coming back to T1, one half cycle. T2 to T0, coming back to T1, another half cycle, 2 cycles. Input signal also completes 2 half cycles, T0 to T1 and T1 to T2, right? So, now these two are said to be synchronized. Both cycles match each other, right? This is synchronized. This is synchronized. 2 cycles of ramp equal to 2 cycles of
two half cycles of input signal. Now, right, look at this waveform. Here, between T0 to T2, two half cycles of ramp or two cycles of ramp is equal to three cycles of input signal, right? Two cycles of ramp equal to, I'm sorry, here you observe that between T0 to T2, T0 to T1, sorry, the ramp completes two cycles, okay? Between T0 to T2, ramp completes two cycles. That is T1 to T2, again coming back to T1, and T1 to T0 coming back to T1, two cycles, right? What about the input signal? Input signal between T0 to T2 completes four cycles. That is T0 to T1, again T2, negative half, positive half. Again another negative half, positive half cycle. So four. So this is synchronized. This is synchronized. Okay? Two cycles of ramp equal to four cycles of input. Synchronize. But look at this. Here, between T0 to T2, between T0 to T2, two cycles of these ramp covers two cycles. Between T0 to T2, it covers two cycles. But the input signal covers only one and a half cycles. Right? So, two cycles of ramp equal to one and a half cycles of input. This is not synchronized. Okay, so when you give the voltage, the signals like this, that is when you give the ramp like this to the horizontal plates and the input signal like this to the vertical plates, you will not be able to observe the waveform. This waveform you cannot observe in the screen. In the screen you will observe the waveform like this only, right? You will observe the waveform like this. See, why? Because during the one cycle from T0 to T2, from the left extreme to the right extreme, when a luminous spot in moves from left extreme to the right extreme, this blue color, the waveform, the portion of the input signal shown in blue color appears, right here. And in the next cycle, again from T2 to T6, of the ramp, now the waveform, the portion of the input signal shown in red color appears again from left extreme to the right extreme. Now you get the waveform like this. You are not getting the correct sinusoidal waveform. This is because of these two signals are not synchronized. Okay, so if it is not synchronized, you will not get the waveform. Actual waveform here, you will get something like this, right? So to avoid this kind of error, erroneous waveform, both the ramp given to the horizontal plates and the input signal given to the vertical plates should be synchronized. How to synchronize? That is, the input signal should be triggered by the ramp signal. The input signal to be triggered by the ramp signal. That is the solution. For that we need a trigger circuit in your CRO. That is called the trigger circuit. Okay. So the output of the input signal is used to trigger the sawtooth waveform. Okay. That is, sawtooth waveform will be generated by the time-based generator only after it is triggered by the input signal. That is, once the input signal comes to the once the input signal is ready and it triggers the sawtooth waveform, then sawtooth waveform is also getting ready and coming to the horizontal plates, both in same time. The time is adjusted by the delay line. Okay, now you will get the right waveform. That is the idea, right? Okay, now we have discussed in detail about the working principle of CRO, and also the internal circuitry of the CRO, right, in detail. This is how the signal is displayed on the CRO screen. But here, see, the screen is coated with the some special material, I said. That is nothing but it depends on the color. The screen is coated with some fluorescent materials like zinc orthosilicate or zinc oxide inside the face of the tube. Right? So when a high velocity electron beam strikes the screen, a spotlight appears because of this property of the material, zinc orthosilicate or zinc oxide or any other material, depends on the color of the luminant display you require. Okay. That's all. So, thank you.